In other news, over 160 foreigners were rescued in a Pogo hub in Cebu. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, or PAO, conducted a raid in a resort in Lapu-Lapu City over the weekend. This after three Indonesian nationals escaped the facility last July and called for help in their embassy. The foreigners were allegedly involved in love scam and cryptocurrency scams. Some of those who were rescued were foreigners who managed to escape the raid in the Lucky South 99 compound in Pampanga.
We were just here to rescue the Indonesian nationals. Kaya lang pagdating po namin dito, in flagrante delicto, caught in the act, nakita namin merong mga scam farm dito. So after our raid in Pampanga, yung mga managers nila, yung mga owners nila, they were brought here. Ito ang first time namin sa PAOK dito sa Cebu City, Cebu Province. But we have heard reports of other possible illegal pogos in this island.
Turning now to the massive manhunt for controversial preacher Apollo Quiboloy. The Philippine police continue barricading the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound in Davao City, with the search entering its ninth day. But this does not stop religious group from celebrating its 39th anniversary Sunday, even without its leader. The PNP did not allow them to hold the event inside the cathedral, where the pastor is believed to have been hiding underground. Vice President Sara Duterte also raised the anniversary celebration. She believes Quiboloy is no longer in Davao City. Tropical storm Enteng wreaking havoc in parts of Luzon and Visayas. A landslide hit Santo Niño village in northern Samar, with at least one reported missing. Power supply was also cut off in the town of Biri. In Camarines Sur, evacuation is underway due to the massive floods. And continuous rains also led to the overflowing of river below the Bontol Bridge in Antique. Meanwhile, a liquor ban has been imposed in Aurora, where wind signal number is hoisted. Over in Naga City, forced evacuation has been implemented across all villages. Naga City Mayor Nelson Legacion announced the order through Facebook Sunday night. He said the tropical storm dumped 2 months worth of rain in just a day. He also warned of more flooding in the city. Malacanang suspends classes in all levels in Metro Manila due to the bad weather. The class suspension covers both private and public schools. Other local government units have also canceled classes for today, September 2, as Tropical Storm Enteng continues to batter parts of the Philippines. Going back to our weather watch, let's get an update on Enteng's track from Pagasa forecaster Glyza Escolyar. Hi Glyza, what do you have for us?
Rainy morning, Bettina, and for the update for Tropical Storm Enteng, Enteng slightly intensify as it slow down over the coastal waters of Benson's Camarines Norte. Last estimated position was at over the coastal waters of Benson's Camarines Norte. The maximum sustained winds is 75 km per hour near the center, and gustiness is up to 90 km per hour. It is forecast to move west-northwest at 10 km per hour. Tropical cyclone signal, wind signal number 2 is up over the northeastern portion of Camarines Norte, northeastern portion of Camarines Sur, eastern portion of Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands, the eastern portion of Isabela, Polillo Islands, the eastern portion of Quirino, and the eastern portion of Kalinga. Meanwhile, tropical cyclone, the wind signal number 1 is up over the southern portion of Batanes, the eastern portion of Ilocos Norte, the eastern portion of Abra, Apayao, the rest of Kalinga, the eastern portion of Mountain Province, the eastern portion of Ifugao, the rest of Cagayan, the rest of Isabela, the rest of Quirino, the eastern portion of Nueva Vizcaya, the rest of Aurora, the eastern portion of Nueva Ecija, the eastern portion of Bulacan, the eastern portion of Rizal, the eastern portion of Laguna, the northern and southern portions of Quezon Province, Marinduque, the rest of Camarines Norte, the rest of Camarines Sur, Albay, Sorsogon, Catanduanes, and the northern portion of Masbate, including Tikau and Burias Island. Meanwhile, due to tropical cyclone Enteng and the southwest monsoon, it is expected that Occidental Mindoro, Oriental Mindoro, Northern Palawan, including Calamian, Coyoacan, Cagayan, Silio Islands, and Antique will have heavy to intense rain, moderate to heavy rains over Zambales, Bataan, Tarlac, Pampanga, Nueva Ecija, the rest of Palawan, the rest of Western Visayas, and Negros Island region. Meanwhile, orange warning was raised over Quezon Province, yellow warning over Metro Manila, Cavite, Batangas, Bulacan, Laguna, Bataan, and it is expected over Zambales in the next hour. That is the latest on the weather from the Weather Forecasting Center of Pag-asa. This is Glyza Escolia reporting.
Hi, Glyza. Just a few questions.
Yes?
It seems that the this tropical storm Enteng didn't actually make landfall, but instead just affected the eastern parts of the country. Am I correct?
That's right, Bettina. However, the most parts of southern Luzon and parts of western Visayas, as well as the eastern part of northern and central Luzon, is affected by the rainfall brought about by this tropical cyclone Enteng and the southwest monsoon.
Glyza, do we see this tropical storm further intensifying before it exits the Philippine area of responsibility?
Yes, Bettina. The expected intensity within the PAR is typhoon category before it exits the Philippine area of responsibility.
And Glyza, maybe you can give us an estimate on when we can expect it to become a typhoon?
This weather system will become a typhoon by Friday, September, that is September 5.
Okay. So when it does become a typhoon, and it seems like it will be skirting the eastward parts of the country as well as the northern parts of the country, so are we expecting heavy rains on maybe Thursday or Friday in northern parts of Luzon?
Yes, Bettina, that is right. Apart from the heavy rains over your mentioned area, it is also expected that tropical cyclone wind signal number 2 and 3 will be up over the northern and eastern portion of northern and central Luzon.
And for my last question, Glyza, as this tropical cyclone moves upward, are we seeing also a possible pull of the southwest monsoon and again affecting western portions of the country, including Metro Manila?
Yes, Bettina, that is right. It is expected to bring a moderate to at times heavy rains over most parts of the western section of northern central Luzon, southern Luzon, as well as the western section of Visayas. Tataguligin ko lang, Bettina, sa ating mga kababayan po dito po sa western section po ng southern Luzon, central Luzon at northern Luzon, maging dito po sa ilang bahagi po ng western section ng Visayas, ina-expect po natin na yung ulan related po sa southwest monsoon ay maaring magtagal po ng 3 hanggang 4 na araw. So I-ready na po ninyo yung mga emergency kit ninyo sakali po magtuloy-tuloy po yung malalakas na pag-ulan in relation to Tropical Cyclone Enteng and the Southwest Monsoon that it will enhance in the coming days.
Oh, Glyce, it looks like kailangan tumutok talaga muna sila ngayon to PAGASA for more of your updates. And it seems like, Glyce, it's going to be a rainy week ahead. Thank you so much for that update, Glyce.
Thank you, Bettina.
Protest grips Israel following the deaths of 6 hostages in Gaza. As frustration mounts with the country's leadership for failing to secure a ceasefire deal that would free Israeli captives. Israel says it recovered the bodies from a tunnel in Gaza where they were apparently killed shortly before troops reached them. An estimated 500,000 people demonstrated in Jerusalem, Tel Aviv, and other cities, demanding that Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu do more to bring home the remaining hostages. Israel's trade union has called for a general strike Monday to further pressure government into securing a hostage deal.
Carmel, Hirsch, and others were supposed to be released on the humanitarian beat of the deal of July 2nd. We know today that the decision not to take the deal killed Carmel. Today, I urge my government and all the states of the world to make a deal. Make it possible, make it happen. It's too late for us. It's too late for Carmel. I will never hug her again. But 101 people can still hug their families. For them, make the deal, save lives.
Netanyahu says Israel would not rest until it caught those responsible. Senior Hamas officials, meanwhile, say Israel's refusal to sign a ceasefire agreement was to blame for the deaths. The recovery of the bodies of Israeli hostages comes as a polio vaccination campaign begins in Gaza. The United Nations, in collaboration with Palestinian health authorities, began to vaccinate 640,000 children in the territory. Israel and Hamas have agreed to brief pauses in their 11-month war to allow the campaign to go ahead. The vaccination drive comes after confirmation last month that a baby was partially paralyzed by the type 2 polio virus, the first such case in Gaza in 25 years.
So far, everything is going to plan. The children are arriving, the families are here, the vaccinations are going well. We have the vaccinations in individual cool boxes to sustain the heat of the day. It seems calm and quiet in the Gaza Strip so far. The humanitarian pause is so far lasting, which is what we need to implement this vaccine campaign. And we will see how things go over the coming days.